Welcome. I am Dr. Thomas Gerber, one of the associate editors of Mayo Clinic Proceedings. In this recording, I will focus on the articles that our editor-in-chief, Dr. William Lanier, has selected as editor's choice and highlights for the January 2014 issue of our journal. Now, 2014 will be an exciting year for Mayo Clinic. We will be celebrating 150 years of patient-centered care since Dr. William Worrell Mayo opened a practice in Rochester, Minnesota in 1864. To help celebrate, we will have on our website a new online-only feature called Mayo Clinic Proceedings Legacy. Each month, this feature will present a historical Mayo figure that played an important role in the development of our journal, or a historic Mayo Clinic Proceedings article that described groundbreaking discovery. As part of Mayo Clinic's sesquicentennial celebration, Mayo Clinic Proceedings will also feature a number of articles that highlight our accomplishments in patient care, education, and research. The first of these articles is this month's editor's choice, entitled Mayo Clinic: 150 Years of Serving Humanity Through Hope and Healing, by Dr. Kerry Olson and Mr. Matthew Dacey from Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. The authors offer insights into the factors responsible for the success of an organization that has been described as what is arguably the leading healthcare brand among U.S. consumers and one of the most powerful service brands in the world. The accompanying editorial, celebrating the sesquicentennial of Mayo Clinic, 150 years of advances in medical practice, education, research, and professionalism, was authored by our editor-in-chief, Dr. William Lanier, from Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. Dr. Lanier discusses the importance of studying the Mayo Clinic story insightfully, as only he can, and the role of Mayo Clinic proceedings in the upcoming sesquicentennial celebration. One of this month's featured highlights is the original article, Systematic Analysis Underlying the Quality of the Scientific Evidence and Conflicts of Interest in Interventional Medicine Subspecialty Guidelines, by Dr. Joseph Feuerstein and colleagues from the Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center and Harvard Medical School in Boston, Massachusetts. Based on a systematic, structured review of guidelines published by interventional medicine subspecialty societies, the authors conclude that most medicine interventional practice guideline recommendations are rooted in low-quality evidence and fail to disclose potential conflicts of interest by authors. The accompanying editorial, Improving the Transparency and Trustworthiness of Subspecialty-Based Clinical Practice Guidelines, by Dr. J. Talwalkar from Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota, discusses how the quality and transparency of clinical practice guidelines can be improved by further education of guideline development panel members and adherence to emerging standards in the field of evidence integration. The other featured highlight in this month's issue is the review article, Drug-Induced Liver Injury, by Dr. Michael Lisey and colleagues from Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. Based on a detailed, expanded PubMed search, the authors discuss the epidemiology, predisposing factors, mechanisms, and treatment, with emphasis on the idiosyncratic, unpredictable form of drug-induced liver injury. Two articles in this month's issue provide teaching exercises for which you can receive up to 1 hour of CME credit each if you complete the appropriate documentation. The first is a concise review for clinicians entitled A Clinician's Primer on the Role of the Microbiome in Human Health and Disease, which was authored by Dr. Sahil Khanna and Pritish Tosh from Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. The other is this month's contribution to our ongoing Symposium on Regenerative Medicine entitled Liver Renewal, Detecting Misrepair and Optimizing Regeneration, which was authored by Mariana Mercado and Dr. Anna May Deal from Duke University in Durham, North Carolina. Video interviews are available with authors of most of the articles mentioned in this recording and some others as well. These interviews can be found on the homepage of Mayo Clinic Proceedings at www.mayoclinicproceedings.org in the lower right-hand corner. New on our website is the interactive Path to Patient feature, which is curated by my associate editor colleague Dr. Lori Erickson from the Department of Laboratory Medicine and Pathology at Mayo Clinic. Each month, Path to Patient will present a pathology image, micrograph, or gross specimen, a brief quiz to test your knowledge with immediate feedback on how you did, and background information on the condition at hand. You will get to see stunning images in this new section. Also on the website, our series entitled Editorial Board and Staff. This month features Dr. James Meschia from Mayo Clinic in Florida, who has been our section editor for neurologic diseases since 2006. And just to remind you, you can find on our homepage a number of online-only features that are not available in the print journal, such as extra residence clinics articles, medical images, stamp vignettes, art and Mayo Clinic, and other materials. Dr. William Lanier, editor-in-chief of Mayo Clinic Proceedings, the entire editorial board, and I sincerely hope that you will enjoy these and the other outstanding articles in the January 2014 issue of our journal. We are sincerely grateful for your interest in and continued loyalty to Mayo Clinic Proceedings. As a preview, the next issue of Mayo Clinic Proceedings, which will go live on our website on February 3, 2014, will contain articles entitled A Prospective Pilot Study of Predictors of Acute Stroke in Emergency Department Patients with Dizziness, Relation of Age with Symptom Severity and Quality of Life in Patients with Fibromyalgia, and Multiple Sclerosis, Current and Emerging Disease-Modifying Therapies and Treatment Strategies. In the meantime, you can watch videos related to our journal content on our YouTube channel. You can also follow us on Twitter and like us on Facebook to stay up to date on online first publications and on breaking news related to our journal content. Direct links to our YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter presences can be found in the upper right-hand corner of our homepage. And when you hear me next time, it will only be 3 more months until spring.
We hope you found this presentation from the content of Mayo Clinic Proceedings valuable. Our journal's mission is to promote the best interests of patients by advancing the knowledge and professionalism of the physician community. If you are interested in more information about us, our homepage is www.mayoclinicproceedings.org. There you will find access information for our social media content, such as additional videos on our YouTube channel or journal updates on Facebook. You can also follow us on Twitter. More information about healthcare at Mayo Clinic is available at www.mayoclinic.com. This video content is copyrighted by Mayo Foundation for Medical Education and Research.